Welcome. Let's look at how to use Talech Mobile and its features. We'll walk you through the typical use of the register functions. Let's start by signing into the app by entering your PIN or by using Touch or Face ID if you have this set up. From the register of Talech Mobile, you can tap on a product to add it to an order. You can also view the products by their categories. If you are adding a service that is charged by the hour, you can tap on it the same as a regular item, and then you can key in the time for the service by hours or minutes. And then you can press Save to calculate the order total. If you want to sell an item that's not in the register, you can use the keypad at the bottom to enter in the price of an item. Once you add the price, you can then tap Add, then it's ready to be sold. If you need to edit an order, you can go to the Cart section. You can tap an item here to edit the quantity, tax, or you can add a note to the item being sold. If you need to remove an item from the order, you can swipe it to the left. If you need to cancel an entire order, you can tap the More button at the top right of the screen. Here, you will also have the option to add a customer to the order. In the Customer section, you can view previous customers, or you can create a new one. You'll need to input the first and last name and an email address for the customer. This is mandatory. There are fields for additional information should you wish to add this. If you need to apply a discount or service charge to an order, you can do this from the cart screen. When you're ready, you can tap the Pay button and select which payment type will be used from the drop-down menu. If the customer is paying with a card, you can tap Charge, and the customer can insert, tap, or swipe their card. Customers can tip and sign on your phone if you accept tips. The customer may not be required to sign for an order based on the value set, depending on your settings. You can text, email, or skip the customer receipt, depending on preferences. You are then brought back to the register screen, ready to assist more customers. If you need to process a return or refund, from the dashboard, you can tap the Order section. There is an Open Orders and Closed Orders tab. Open orders are orders that have not received a complete payment. Closed orders have received 100% payment. In our example, we're going to the Closed Order tab. All orders are in chronological order, with the most recent on top. You can use the search bar to find a transaction by order number, first or last name of the customer, and more. You can then tap to recall the transaction and choose between the refund or return option. If needed, you can also resend the customer receipt from this screen. You can select any items from the order that need to be returned. If the items have multiple quantities, you can adjust the amount being returned. You will then tap the refund button and confirm the refund. You can then choose the receipt option. If you need to process a refund that isn't the full amount of an order or item, you can do this from the register by clicking the keypad screen when your cart is empty. If you select the three dots in the top right, you'll see the Create Refund option. You can tap this. A prompt to continue to refund mode or return to payment will appear. Select Continue in Refund Mode. You can then enter the desired refund amount. Make sure it's the correct amount and then tap Add, then Refund. You can then swipe, tap, or insert the card being refunded, and click Refund again. You can then choose the receipt option. Your daily sales numbers are reported in real time. They are recorded on the dashboard. If you prefer more detailed reporting, please log in to talech.com to view in-depth reports. From here, you can get a comprehensive view of payment types, product sales, and much more. If you'd like to learn about setting up invoices, configuring service charges, or more, please visit our help site for articles regarding this. Thank you for watching.